to the channel. Today we've got a playthrough of Alone in the Dark for you all, and this is one I've been really excited to check it out. And thanks to THQ Nordic, who did send across this advanced copy so we could get this put together for you all. Now, if you just want to hear our final opinion on the game, head over to XP Corner, where you will find our review live right now. I'm going to be putting that in the pinned comment down below. Now, before we do jump in, I do want to say there's two options in regards to visuals with this game. You've got quality mode and performance. The preset is performance, so we're going to be sticking with that today and kind of just going from there. All right, let's get into it. All right, so difficulty on combat. Three options. You've got easy, take it easy, focus more on the story. The standard experience with its intended difficulty, and hard for an extra challenge. Today we're going to be going standard, and then difficulty guidance. So it looks like it's preset to mod, and extra help provided to make the experience smoother and easier, including hints and helpful highlights. Difficulty can be switched through the options menu as you play. Old school, those who want to figure out everything for themselves, no extra systems to guide the player. We'll go with modern, as that appeared to be the preset for the game, but it's nice to know there's another option there, especially for replayability. I wonder if the puzzles do change though, so if my next playthrough will everything be identical. Damn, that frog just got screwed. I never want to live anywhere where there's concerns about gators crossing the road as I'm driving down it. That'd be a worrying place to be. I know David Harbour's one of the main stars. I can't remember the actress's name, though. Hopefully it's just like a cinematic kind of styled pre-credit sequence. Gotta admit, though, it's good to be back. Like, Alone in the Dark's been long.
So, your uncle... What's wrong with him?
He's possessed.
As in the devil?
Something like that. He says a dark man is following him.
Sounds about right.
Watching him at all times.
What do you make of it?
It's nonsense, of course. But I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me. You see, it runs in my family.
Possession?
No, detective. Deteriorating melancholy. Practically every member of the Hartwood family is driven mad before they grow old.
But Jeremy didn't kill himself. Is that why he's at your setup?
Despite being convinced that he is truly possessed, he decided to put his last chips on Dr. Gray and his psychoanalysis, figuring he might stumble upon some cure.
You mentioned the letter.
I received a disturbing letter from Jeremy accusing the staff and all the other patients of being involved in some cult. And now they are also out to get him.
Could it be real? Or is it all just in his head?
It's a story he tells himself, Mr. Carnby. Anything to avoid the truth.
Which is?
That we're all terribly insignificant. That people mean so very little to one another. That there is no one out to get Jeremy Hartwood because he isn't worth getting.
Here we are.
My uncle's not well, Mr. Carnby. I want to make sure he's all right.
Then what's my part in this? You couldn't get a cab?
I just wouldn't feel safe going alone. Did you bring a gun?
Yeah. You think it'll actually come to that?
No. But you might need to wave it around depending on how agreeable the staff will be.
What exactly are we gonna do when we find Jeremy?
I don't know. Let's just find him first.
All right, choose a character time. We'll make sure we don't speak through any of the different cutscenes. So we've got Emily Hartwood. Oh, there's the actress, Jodie Comer. Not sure if I know her from anything. And then, of course, we've got David Harbour, who is from Stranger Things, amongst many other. The surprisingly good Gran Turismo movie, and so on. Let's go, David.
Hello? Hello?
Looks abandoned.
It can't be. There has to be someone around.
Wait here. I'll go around back.
Should have chose her. Could have just stood at the front door. I wonder if I chose her, she's the one who goes into the garage. All right, let's see what's going on. So, look for a way inside the house. Nothing that I can search by the looks of things.
It's too dark in here.
There's gotta be a flashlight. Oh, where? Am I going crazy? Oh, here we go. Idiot.
No, perfect. Here.
Very nice. And a key to the kitchen garden. Okay, yeah, okay, cool. All right. That's what we want. So let's get down. Was there anything in here? Do you know what? It looks pretty. I mean, it's one room, but it looks pretty nice. I know it's. Let's put it dead end. Yeah, it looks pretty nice. Oh, that does not sound good. Alright. Kitchen garden key. Thank you very much. This place looks like it's been abandoned for a while. Okay, what's going on over here?
Nah, I'm not getting in there.
What about if you just shoot it though? Do you know, let's not waste ammo. That'd be stupid. Okay, seems like it's gonna be pretty linear, this opening section. It's trying to push me into the location. Damn.
This one big tree defends at a conservatory.
Okay, let's go. What's down here?
I need the key.
Okay. Looks like it's going to be one of those experiences. We need lots of keys. No. That door doesn't do anything. Nor do you. What's there? Beautiful. Bullets are only a good thing, that is for sure. Maybe I'm not supposed to be in the conservatory just yet. Maybe I was wrong about it being linear. Oh, simply free up. So it's gotta be in here, so I'm just missing the key for that door, obviously. Alright, where could you be? You're going to be around here somewhere, I imagine. No. Nope. Oh, here we go. What are you? That's what we needed. Alright. Thank you. Find the front door and let Emily Hartwood inside.
Don't mind if I do.
We'll take that. So alcohol is our medicine. The first time I've heard that. Family Bible.
Every day your silence weighs a little heavier. It's been a difficult year for everyone, and many have lost all hope. I read in the papers about people suffering. Pictures of dust-covered landscapes without a drop of water. I wish I knew if you were still tending the earth or if you had turned your back against us. I have started to look for help elsewhere. I pray you will tell me if I'm going down a path that you find.
All right, so I think I'm going to skip over listening to the audio because it's pretty... it's pretty long, as you can see. Seeing some receipts down here, though, so that might be a clue. Numbers. This seems to be... It's all being added into my investigation notes, so these are things you can reference in the future anyways. But if you do want that extra bit of lore, I guess it is there if you want to dive in. All right, cool. Where are we going next? Good kitchen. Anything we can find around here? I think at the early stage of a game like this, you just need to... You need to focus on finding collectibles, pickups, like this health, bullets, you know, all that good stuff, because it's really going to no doubt get harder as it goes on. Kind of that, you know, that's the idea, isn't it? Kind of scarce resource. I know we chose the modern setting as well, so that's going to make it maybe a little bit easier, but also that is a dungeon. I'm not going down there just yet. That seems like a bad move to me. I want to get to the front door. I need to let that in. Perfect. This looks good. Okay. Let's go down there. Yeah, let's just go down here. Okay. What's in here? That door's open. That seems promising. We open you. More booze. Diary. Sunday, what's going on here? Pain medication inside the grand parlor. Strange rot. All highlighted. So I presume... It's telling me somewhere, something in relation to where I can go later in the game, maybe. Spent all day looking for Jeremy. Okay. We'll keep that for later. Nothing over here. Can we open this? That's locked. Okay, we'll come back to that, though, because medicine's going to be something we need. Floor panel. Okay, that's what I want. Maps. Perfect. Map will really be useful. We want to get to our front door, don't worry. Oh, wait. Why was that one in pink then a second ago when you looked at the map? Let me get back up. Touchpad, is it? Yeah, touchpad. Okay. So it's going to be updated with information about the world. That's always good. There's the pink room. Blue, where the white dots. Change the floors as well. So it looks like we've got four floors in this building. I forgot to... What was the pink again? They explored. That's the one. Okay. All right, let's get to this front door, shall we? Is this the... that's the courtyard from earlier. Okay. And then... nice old bear statue. Let's get to this front door. Is it this one? No, it's got to be the next one, I think. Oh, what's in here? Let's just get to the door and we'll go Okay. See what's going on.
Thanks.
What are you doing? Who are you?
Whoa, pardon me, excuse me. My name is Edward Carnby, private investigator. I hope you don't mind we let ourselves inside.
I do mind. This is private property. You can't just barge in here.
I'm sorry about all this, but I'm looking for my uncle. It's urgent, and no one was answering the door.
We can't hear you knocking anymore. None of us can.
Who is your uncle, darling?
Jeremy. Am I right? She has that Hartwood gloom, doesn't she?
That's right. I'm Emily Hartwood. I just came to make sure my uncle is all right.
Well, he is unavailable right now. You will have to come back another day.
Unavailable? How? Is he sleeping? We can wait.
He's lost.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
Who's your man again, Miss Hartwood?
My name's Edward Carnby, private investigator.
Splendid.
Enough, all of you. Get back to your rooms. McCarthy, keep your eyes on the child. And you two, please leave immediately.
Look, we're not here to cause any trouble. Just let us see the old man, satisfy the curiosity of my client here, and we'll be off.
Jeremy has gone missing. There's no need to worry, but it might be some time before he turns up. The whole staff is looking for him.
What? He ran off?
I don't have time for any of this. Please, come back tomorrow.
All right, in that case, we'll just wait in his room. You don't mind, do you? It's upstairs, right?
Wait, you can't.
Don't worry, we'll be discreet.
In the corridor. It's the first door on your left. I'll tell Dr. Gray you're here.
Excellent. Thank you, madam. Here we are.
Let's look around. See if we can dig up any clues.
It's like a nasty little flash there when it cuts from a cutscene to gameplay. I don't remember the original game. I played it back in the day, a long time ago. I think one of my family members had it or something, so we played it over like a Christmas period. But it reminded me of... Oh no. That weirdo cast just kind of gave me like Shining vibes almost. Steam trunk. Alright, what's going on here? So there's got to be something around here. We've got a puzzle box. Got the option to talk to her. The commonplace
every
book.
Every night the dark man stands opaque at the...
Stop this. Dark man, so that's the guy he said was following him. You look the same to my father as he struggled for his life. Does he fail to face haunt my niece quite the same way? They've gone to town on the text with this game. Battered boiler in the basement would lead me to the cemetery. Or how the old upstairs clock, astronomical murders would take me to that hateful mound outside of Claremont Harbor. Those are my memories, my past. Is there perhaps a chance, if ever so small, for me to see Teruella? I think I'm saying that right. I want that more than anything. Please let my talisman take me there. Let me sit with Juan under his body tree. Having sold me that talisman, Miss Jackson, the foodie priestess. No secrets. Dr. Gray is mentioned here. He's caught up in treating me. The orderlies, the housekeeper, the patients are all deranged. I second that opinion from what we just saw. The clerk, Mr. Waits, he seems to be a clear-thinking man. All right. Kind of got the cliff notes there. Hey, that's what we wanted. All right, perfect. So painted wooden tile, and the motif suggests that it's been part of a larger picture. Let's go and get this sorted, shall we? Select. All right, so you go down there. You there. It definitely didn't go for challenging, but it is the first puzzle, I guess.
Hey, you know anything about this? Looks like some sort of talisman.
No, I don't. Oh, help me out here, will you?
Oh, kill the guy, throw some of this stuff out? I'd be crazy too if I had this much junk lying around.
Oh, wow. That's striking. I want to save this one.
Looks a bit like Willem Dafoe.
All right, come on. I want to go see Dr. Gray. Come on, let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming. Miss Hartwood. Emily?
All right, now things are going to get a little bit weird, I imagine. All right, cool. I like the cutscenes. The cutscenes have a few little nods to like the old static camera angles and stuff, which is a nice touch. I guess. Okay. What is that floating around? It's nice. Do I shoot or do I wait for him to come to me? Oh, crap. Did not expect that. That was a trap. It's not very nice. I did just see more, but I don't know if the frame rate struggled a little bit there with that first attack. Unless it was just the animations. Okay. Let's keep going.
I can't go that way.
Oh, invisible walls. Alright. Let's see if there's anything we can at least get more bullets.
What the hell is going on?
Wait, what? That was super quick, that was. It seems the lights are on this building, which tells me we want to go there. Beautiful. More bullets, lots of bullets, lots of booze. Let's see what's going on with Johnny the Conqueror. Roots and medicines.
Your store?
There are no owners here. We both strangers in Jeremy's store.
Jeremy did this. How?
The pact with the dog man. Jeremy warned us, but we didn't think much of it.
I'm Detective Edward Carnby. I was hired by Jeremy's niece to find him.
Oh, yeah? How much she paying you?
$150.
She's sure getting her money's worth tonight. Are you a thinking man, compare?
Not if I can help it.
You know, I think Jeremy's hiding in a way we can't find him. He has this juju necklace that guides him.
The talisman?
That's right. It's some magic charm he got from Miss Jackson down the street.
The voodoo priestess?
You know surprising things, compadre. Yeah, the Mama Loa. Here, take the key. I locked the gate to save her place from all the ghouls and goblins getting inside. Maybe if you go there, you can find some clues to show you the way.
Thanks. I'll have a look.
Alright, so there's three keys on the chain. One that opens up to Miss Jackson's place in the French Quarter. Then there are two belonging to DeSetto. One for the clerk's office and one for the library. Cool. Nice. More ammo. Preserved reptile. Open it. Oh, okay. Have we meant like open the jar? Cool. So collectibles. More bullets. More bullets. There must be a ton of enemies coming up. Let's get on back here. I want to see if I chat to you. What's going on?
You want to come along?
Nah, I'm gonna stay here for a while.
Well, that was pointless. Let's get back outside then in that case. So I got the keychain. Let's go down here then. It's the only way left, isn't it? I like the monster designs. Alright, let's leave him for just a second.
Hey.
They are bullet sponges. I can see why they're giving me loads of ammo. Wait, is there anything? Where did he even come from? Alright. Let's do... Hello? Service, please. Items for any items are used to track. Tap R2 to quickly throw the item. Hold R2 to aim. But what items? Oh, there we go. Do you have anything on you? Nope. Well, that's a dead end. Alright, let's go down there. I'm just going to investigate as much as possible. Oh, nice. Hatchet. Love that. Anyone out here?
I can't go that way.
Alright. Yeah, I think... Is there any way to see the weapons you have? No. Let's open this up. You know there's going to be enemies down here. Alright. Okay, one up there. Oh. Here you go. Let's just see if we can get their attention. I don't mind it when I can see them. It's when you can't. Oh, that's horrible. Boom. Oh, the axe. I'm feeling the axe. Anyone else? Let's go stairs. Let's go axe mode.
My weapon broke.
Oh crap, weapons broken. Ah, go. Horrible aiming right there from there. Jesus. Just die already. Tight when you're in the stairs. There we go. Well, I can see why he gives you so many bullets. I'm down to one already. Is it? What's this? That's something I can throw. More bullets, thank you. Need some sort of like handheld weapon as well. Is that bullets down there? No. Don't go in there yet. I want that. Thank you.
I recognize this place. It's Miss Jackson's seance parlor. Let's see if she's got any information on Jeremy's talisman.
So the lighting just changed then for the game. You saw a flick. I was just going to see if it happened again when I came back in. Alright, cool. What's going on here? So here's the talisman.
It's the talisman, like the one in the painting.
An old talisman shaped over centuries, the engraving of the numbers looks to be less than 100 years old, but the base could be from antiquity. The polished black sunstone in the middle has a glass finish and occasionally gives the impression of hiding a picture within itself. Use the talisman to get... someone here? Well, first of all, before I do try and get back... what is there to loot? Guess I can't do anything there. Alright, I guess it's going home then.
I think it's meant for the talisman.
Alright, well done, Sherlock.
I think it needs numbers, like coordinates.
Okay, let's have a look at this. Let's go on notes. Schematics, maybe? Three numbers needed to span a bridge between the scapes of dream and memory, according to Stan. Not where I want to be, but it's a start. So 3, 5, 8. Nice.
Something in Jeremy's notes.
Am I doing this the right way? Let's see if we can just reset this a second. Can we? Nice. Let's So it's 358. So we try the, let's try this way. So 3, 5. I don't understand. Oh, I'm an idiot. The number's on the right-hand side of the bloody screen. Let's go 3, 5. How about that? Anything change? Let's go this way then. Hey, okay, I did the wrong way around.
It's showing something. A place? Where is that?
That's there, isn't it? That's his table.
Huh.
Well, there's the door I wanted to open.
Detective, I was wondering when you were going to show up. Mrs. Thompson told me you were here. I understand you are working for Jeremy Hartwood's niece.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, you're not wrong. We came here for her uncle. I just didn't expect... I didn't expect this. You are Dr. Gray, right?
That's right. You don't happen to have some identification, Detective. I'm not keen on having strangers prying into my business. Oh, Detective Edward Carnby, Decatur Street, New Orleans. Enjoying the Vieux Carré, Detective? Those old French quarters, the voodoo people, the gangsters. I'm sure you live an exciting life.
Well, it's not quite like the stories, Doc. Just trying to make a living.
Aren't we all making a living? Well, welcome to DeSetto, Detective. I hope your time here will be useful. Now, what can I do for you?
Why don't you tell me where I can find Jeremy Hartwood?
Why wouldn't that make for a short visit? I wish I could tell you, but I'm afraid I don't know. A drink, Detective?
Anything brandy.
Oh, you do belong in the French quarters, Detective. Armagnac or cognac?
You know, just give me the cheap stuff. I'm not much of a connoisseur.
Having low standards is not a virtue, Detective. Let me see if I can broaden your perspective.
What can you tell me about Jeremy?
I wouldn't want to go into details about his condition. Doctor-patient confidentiality. I'm sure you understand.
Sure. But he is crazy. And he's gone missing. Why?
Here. Try this.
Ooh, it's good. Got a bite?
It's called a side. The trick is not to be afraid of the tartness of the lemon. Then, for goodness sake, don't overdo the triple sec.
Okay, what can you tell me about Jeremy?
Well, let me think. He is an anxious man, constantly worried about events not presenting themselves according to his model of predestination. He complains about things not being carried out in the right order, and that some things simply shouldn't be. Is any of this helpful to you?
Not really. I was hoping for some direction where to look next.
I'm sorry. I have nothing for you then. You should talk to my orderlies. They have been looking for him for a while now. I'm sure they would appreciate your help.
Yeah, I ran into Baptiste earlier. Come to think of it, he might have given me a lead.
Oh, excellent. So your investigation is already underway.
I'm gonna go, but I'm sure we'll meet again.
Looking forward to it. Safe returns.
Detective Carnby, how did you... Where did you go?
I was just talking to Dr. Gray.
You disappeared?
No, it's not what you think. Have you found anything strange going on here?
Yes. Everyone is being incredibly evasive and I can't figure out why.
No, I mean something you can't explain. Paranormal, even.
Detective? I really need you to get yourself together. I can't do this alone.
Forget it. I'll figure it out.
Do you want to come see Dr. Gray?
No. I want to try something. With this talisman, I think I can follow Jeremy to the place he mentioned in the book. What was the name? Do you remember something Spanish? Tarawea. Yeah, that's where I need to go.
Detective, are you going to be all right?
Yeah, of course. Go talk to Dr. Gray. We'll rendezvous later.
This talisman brought me back from the French Quarter in the blink of an eye. If Jeremy can travel so easily, then he could be hiding anywhere, even Tarawea. If he can do it, so can I. I just need to figure out how the talisman works.
All right, cool. So that's the end of chapter one. I think we'll leave it there for this part of the video. Tune in, though, for the rest of the series. I'm not sure how many parts it's going to be at this point. I'm going to see if I can do it chapter by chapter, but I imagine that was kind of just like a, almost like a prologue chapter, so it may be quite a bit shorter. So we'll see how it gets on. But again, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed it, subscribe. And again, remember the review is now live over on XP Corner. I'm going to be linking that in the pinned comment down below. All right, thanks everyone.